Mick, two games left of a long old season. How are you feeling and how the squad feeling?
I'm feeling great. Obviously very disappointed after the other evening when we conceded a late goal. But that's our job, to get back up again, get the players back focused and ready to go again. Yeah, two games left and we're in a real, real good place, a real good position. We wouldn't swap with anything really in terms of where we are, and we're just looking forward to the next game.
I mean, there were no signs of nerves on Tuesday night, so is there any likely to be any this Saturday?
Well, I hope not. I mean, some of the football the other evening was excellent. Arguably some of the best football of the season in terms of the way we create the chances, we got in great positions. We should have seen the game out, we should have put the game to bed. Maybe a slight bit of mismanagement at the end in terms of conceding a sloppy goal on our behalf. They would say it was a good goal on their behalf, but when you look back at it, there was a few instances where we could have stopped at the source, so we're disappointed in that. But overall, the two performances over Easter, I thought, were excellent.
I mean, there will be some fans who are nervous, but I suppose that's just the nature of this business, isn't it? We know what it's like.
Well, we're all nervous. We're human beings. We get edgy. Everyone gets edgy and nervous at this stage of the season. I mean, it's an old cliche. It's hard to get over the line. It's tough to get your team over the line. And it's every club in the league, and every club in every league is finding it very hard to get teams over the line. And especially in this league, with the records that have been broken by other teams, the points that's been amassed by teams, it'll be some kind of record this season, I'm sure.
I suppose, though, the way your side are playing and have been playing, one defeat in 30 or whatever it is, suggests that, you know, you're playing well, so you don't have too much to worry about.
We are playing well. One defeat in that long period with some excellent football, but it just goes to show you. I mean, if in past years, if we'd had these points by now, we'd be promoted, but we're not. It just goes to show there's some really good teams at this level, some really good teams on great runs, some really good teams playing well. We are one of those teams that are doing very well at the moment, and we've just got to try and amass as many points as we can.
Is there a determination in your squad after what happened on Tuesday as to, right, let's now finish this off, because they'll be annoyed, we know that, as a bunch of players?
I think there is a steely determination amongst all of us, and especially the players. They've been determined from day one to try and get out of this league, and we've progressed and moved forward. And it was disappointing the night, but we had a meeting this morning. We had a good chat. And the players are, there's, as you say, they've got the determination, the will, and the desire, also the skill and the ability, in my opinion, to get us over the line.
It happened at Carlisle last season, and it's kind of similar circumstances again. Will you look at the other games that are going on, those other two that are pivotal?
Well, 100% the crowd will let us know what the score is elsewhere, whatever. We've just got to look after ourselves. As we've said all along, ever since day one I was put in this role, we just got to look after ourselves, our results, how we perform, excuse me, how we go about our business. And I'm sure the knowledgeable Luton Town fans will let us know what the scores are at other grounds.
How is your squad? Have you got any problems from Tuesday night?
No problems, no. No injury update. Alan McCormack and Dan Potts are back on the grass training, so hopefully they might have an influence over the last two games.
Sheehan, is he done for the season, or might he be back at all?
We don't know. Alan's got an Achilles problem, and it's unlikely that Alan will be involved over the weekend.
And for the goalkeeping situation, is that going to give you something to think about this week? Because if he's back from illness, Shay, you may have to think about who goes in between the sticks.
It will do. It gives us a bit of a slight headache. Marek's gone in and done very well. James came out of the team through illness. Played over 38 games, I think he played, and kept goal very well. So it's a decision we've got to make over the weekend, over the next few days, about which goalkeeper we're playing on Saturday.
And for you as the manager, Mick, have you got to try and be calm and show your players that, you know, you're as calm as anybody else and that you think they're going to get over the line?
That's been part of our chats. You know what I mean? We need to be calm, we need to be relaxed, we need to play with our hearts but think with our heads. That's the key message we send out to all the players, to the staff, for all the staff to be positive around the players, for everyone in the building to be positive, because as we've said all along, we're in a very, very good position. And at the start of the season, we'd have taken this.
Cool. Yep.
How much do you think the goal will boost Elliott as well from Tuesday night? Because it was a good finish and he'd been involved with that one, hadn't he?
Yeah, Elliott had spent a long time without a goal. I'd spoken to Elliott. We had a one-to-one and Elliott was full of confidence. He believes he knows his own ability as a number 10. He's very good for this football club, the way we tried to play. And yeah, obviously the goal will be a massive boost for him, and I'm absolutely thrilled for him because he works his socks off in training. He's a good link as a 10, and he's been very good for us, so the goal will hopefully help him.
You mentioned he'd saw a little bit of criticism about his own performances online by some supporters. Has that been disappointing to hear that some fans had said that about him at all?
Well, Elliott's probably his worst critic in himself, you know, in terms of how he plays and what he wants to do, and he knows when he's playing well and he's not playing well. It hasn't affected him because, I mean, when he gets picked, he goes out there, gives 100%. We have got a good cover in George Moncur, so we're well covered in that position. So Elliott and George are fighting out for that position. So it's good competition and healthy competition.
And just in Burn as well. I mean, they've, especially at home, they've picked up some really good results, haven't they? I mean, pushed Portsmouth close, but beaten some of the top teams as well. So it's a difficult proposition, isn't it?
Good team, Portsmouth. Burton, sorry. Good team. I saw them play against Portsmouth. I was at the game. Unlucky to lose the way they play. They play a certain type of brand of football, the way Nigel wants to play. They're a good footballing team. Yeah, it'll be a tough ask for us.
Do you think the fact they've got nothing to play for has any bearing on it at all, because they can't even get the playoffs now?
Hopefully. That's what you want. You want to play a team that's got nothing to play for. But knowing Nigel as I do, I've known him down the years, played against him. He'll be desperate to beat the team at the top of the league. And they're a good team. The team are good professionals, and I'm sure he'll put a strong team out.
Dan Potts, is he any closer, or do you think he'll miss for the rest of the season as well now?
Well, Potts's back on the grass again. Which is great news for us. We don't know yet. We'll just have to see how he reacts over the last couple of days whilst he's been training.
The PFA team came out for the league as well last week. You had James Collins and James Dustin in it. I mean, it's good to have two players in it, but again, do you think you could have had a few more maybe?
Well, like every other manager and coach, they always think their team should have more players in. We're just thrilled that we had two players in and we've got the player of the season. Rightly so, and James Collins. So it's not our decision, it's the other players' decision. They've made their minds up, so we'll accept that. But we've got some good players here, and I think a few of the players who never made it will be slightly disappointed, but that's the way it is.
Just one final thing, there'll be over 1,700 going up to the Pirelli Stadium and potentially another 1,000 back at Kenilworth Road watching the game. Sold out again the other night, support was phenomenal, and it's ongoing, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. They are up there with the best fans in the country. What the club has been through in the past years, and the support of the club to the hilt. All I can do is send a message to them, say thank you very much for your support. It's well appreciated, and the players will 100% definitely up for the next two games to try and get us over the line.
Okay.